Are you threatening me? What is up, everyone, and welcome back. If you ever encounter one of those stories that is so crazy, so nuts, so utterly insane and mind-boggling, that it just couldn't possibly be fake, that it has to be true because you simply couldn't make this up. The story of Threaten is one of those stories. This is so ridiculous that you just couldn't make this stuff up. The band or individual known as Threaten, known as Jared Threaten, a Los Angeles-based rock musician who helms a kind of third or fourth rate 80s glam band by the name of Threaten, managed to book an entire European tour, but he doesn't actually have a band. They're hired guns, and he doesn't actually have fans. It turns out his social media presence, all the followers, all the views, they're all purchased. They're all paid for by someone bankrolling the band. They managed to get an entire European tour, but without a fan base. The booking company, the promotions company, Stage Right Bookings, is apparently his company. I and others that have done research cannot find anything linking them to anyone else other than Jared Threaten. Stories are coming out from bands that have played these gigs, from the venues themselves, that none of their fans have shown up, even though they were promised and guaranteed hundreds of pre-sales. From the other bands that have played these shows, they said the majority of the crowd has come from their fans that they brought along. So an entire tour has been booked from a band that doesn't have any fans and doesn't really exist. The whole thing is a scam concocted by somebody associated with Threaten or Threaten himself. And the word Threaten takes on a whole new meaning in 2018. When you say, are you threatening me? You're no longer saying, are you going to hurt me in some way? Saying, are you threatening to create a fake band and a fake Facebook page and all of these fake followers and then screw hardworking bands and hardworking clubs out of money and time? It's absolutely and utterly ridiculous that in this day and age, you could get away with something like this. Because the internet and social media is so vast. People are on it 24 hours a day. Billions of people across the world use it. And I'm truly and utterly shocked that these bands and these venues did not do their homework. When I used to book and promote, I did tons of research on anybody that I booked. And even as a local band, I'd contact other bands just to find out how the bands act. Are they professional? Will they show up on time? Will they load in on time? Will they load off on time? And I also talked to other promoters. If they dealt with a band that wasn't good or that had issues, I wouldn't book them. And bands that I helped manage wouldn't gig with them because of those issues. The fact that nobody did their homework on any of these venues absolutely astounds me. And it's hilarious. It's also really sad. And it's sad because it's going to screw other bands and other promoters. And it's already screwed bands and promoters. These guys are going to take a loss. They might be less likely or less apt to book bands that they don't know Or they might even be, they might even scrutinize things more heavily because of this. So it screws all of these hardworking bands because of this guy and whoever's behind him backing him and all this wanting to defraud people of their hard-earned cash and their hard-earned time. So that part sucks. I know there are plenty of bands in scenes that I get the chance to cover here on the channel, Portuguese scene, the Japanese scene, the lesser-known VK bands and what have you, that would absolutely kill for the opportunity to tour Europe or to come over to the U.S. and tour the U.S. and actually get booked. Never mind headline these gigs. So clearly, we've all been doing it the wrong way. I've been doing the channel the wrong way. All these bands out there that are busting their butts, working hard, getting their music out there, getting a hold of PR reps and people like myself, trying to get honest opinions and feedback and promotion. Instead, you can just create a fan base and fabricate everything. Spend some money and book an entire European tour. Now, it's not a massive European tour, but the fact that this got booked to begin with boggles my mind. Link to the Metal Sucks article will be down in the description below. He has since locked down all of his social media accounts, disabled all the comments on all the videos. The Facebook page is gone, or at least it's deactivated. You can't get access to his Twitter feed, that you can't still tag him. It's hilarious. It's unbelievable, and people are furious. In a way, no publicity is good or bad publicity, because he's certainly going to get plenty of it. At the same time, these booking agents and clubs are going to talk to each other, and he's not going to be able to get a gig. And if your deal, if promoters and venues have dialogues, we talk to each other, we deal with each other, because you don't want to get hosed. It's your business, it's your livelihood, and you know you want to be great to bands that are coming up, and you want to be able to do the best for them when they come through. This ruins it for everybody. Bands are going to have a harder time trying to get shows. So, dude, you are a terrible human being. I'm not going to curse on the channel, but you were a vile human being. You screwed it up for a lot of people. At the same time, you've given us a ton of entertainment, because this truly is one of those things you just can't make up. Now, in the threaten will have to be inserted into the dictionary. Your face will have to be alongside it so people can look at your whiny nasally mug. And when somebody says, "Are you threatening me?" it's going to take on a whole new meaning because of you, brother. So, are you threatened by Mr. Threaten, Mr. Jerry Threaten here? Let me know in the comments below. Let me know what you think. Let me know how vile you think this human being is. Go check out the Metal Sucks article. They did a great job. They typically do when it comes to stuff like this. This is a good one, ladies and gentlemen. At the same time, it's one of those things that's so bad and terrible, it wraps around to become utterly hilarious. Thanks for checking it out, getting a laugh or two. I love you guys. Thank you to my law enforcement, military veterans, and first responders for what you guys do every single day. As always, you have been awesome. I have been Bald Man. I'll see you in the next one. Be excellent to each other. Keep headbanging, and don't threaten me.